Yeah, seriously, it's not a countdown, it's a count up.
I didn't actually call it a countdown that time, so.
Hey, everybody, welcome back to another episode of Warp Just Does Retro Gaming. I am actually joined this evening by a whole lot of people, which makes me very happy again. We're going to go top and bottom here on my group list. So, starting from the top, we've got Kithis.
What's up, everybody?
Next to them, we've got Carolyn.
Oh, hi.
My lovely wife. Then we've got Adderall. Or Adderall. Or
Adderall. Adderall.
I don't know. I kind of like Adderall, personally.
Yeah, he needs to take some Adderall.
I was just thinking that.
And next to that, we've got Fat Betty.
Fat Betty.
Hi, I'm Bitty Betty.
And then finally, Sir Blast-A-Lot.
Hey, guys.
So, for those, most of the people who have seen a few of the episodes here, you'll be familiar with who everybody is. If not, we'll try to associate appropriately. But we've got Kithis, who is Hydros Inc. on the.
Oh, the Barbarian!
Who's better known by his Thum.
God, my piss not
coming back. We've got Sir Blast, that's a.k.a. AC Gamer. And then, you guys don't really kind of sort of have a channel, but not a channel, or a channel coming soon. I'm kind of in the dark here. Where do we sit?
He's waiting on equipment. So.
Yeah, it was supposed to have been here the 15th, but you know how the mail stuff goes and ordering stuff from eBay.
Holy crap, that giant rat killed my pet.
You order equipment for a sex change on eBay is what happens.
Hey, at least he's doing it before puberty.
That rat stunned me.
Fair enough.
Incoming giant sewer rat.
Woohoo! Sounds like a blast.
Where's my pet?
Your pet is dead.
No, I just summoned him again.
Oh. He's invisible.
I know, I hate that.
Gotta love the air pets.
Yeah, he's a... No, I don't want to drop him on the ground. Ah, I wish there was a way. Let's see. Sit? No, not sit. Guard? Oh, guard's not working. Back?
Yourself say attack.
Incoming two mercenaries.
No. Two mercenaries. Oh, I do have CMVs, I think. Or is that my druid that has CMVs? Oh, wow.
Damn.
Oh, there you are, Viber.
You just one-shotted that, homie.
Yeah, Viber, he's tough, man.
I couldn't even get a cast off of these guys.
Yeah, we may be here too long. We might need to move further into the zone if we're killing that quickly.
I know a space we can go. There's some blue frog locks.
You know, actually,
we're not going nowhere until I get at least one earring. I'm the only one without one.
What's that zone that's right past the newbie zone at Qeynos, AC? The one where the...
Qeynos Hills?
Yeah, the Qeynos Hills. That would be a really good place for us to go and get experience, too.
Yeah, or over there in Everfrost Peaks as well. I mean, that's that has that whole newbie area.
Yeah, Everfrost.
Because you guys do want to run over to Blackboro anyways, so.
All right.
Yeah.
As soon as we get me an earring.
You really want that earring, man. That's all he's been talking about all night, guys. So we are going to get him his earring.
I have sat here and...
Let me give you the one that you gave me, so we can move.
Oh, that's a nice gift, man, and it's the holiday season. So
are you talking about the alligator thing, brother? Earring?
Yeah, yeah. Happy Halloween, dude.
Yeah, I love
scare
you.
Crap out.
Oh,
not give.
Oh, well. Come on, Benny, Benny.
Underwear, dude. That's been in your ear. I am not putting that in mine.
It's been other places.
That I do not doubt.
Here we go again. Oh, hey, level guys, 6.
As you know, oh,
congrats, man. Yeah, level 6.
As you all know, guys, everybody who's watching, this is a kid-friendly video series.
Oh, totally.
We're just got picked up by our
Nickelodeon.
Time after being Rainbow.
Did you say Reading Rainbow?
Reading Rainbow.
I, Burton. I love that as a kid, man.
Yeah,
what was the one with Bill Cosby? What was the one? Bill Cosby had a little show where he had.
Is that the one where he drew on the board with the marker?
Wait. Yeah, with the marker. Yeah. That was a cartoon.
You're talking Bill Cosby and family friendly after recent.
Yeah, Bill Cosby. he probably had a lot of families out there after all that. You know.
There you go, golden locket, right? That's what you were looking for.
So, are we going to stop calling it Slipter or Mickey and start calling it Slipter or Cosby?
I already have one.
Can we make that a thing?
Have you seen the recent episode of one of the recent episodes of South Park that had the hot Cosby?
There is a place we can go and get more XP.
Yep.
Yeah, I would say
it's just down below.
Well, I thought Kithis gave you the one that he had hidden, you know, someplace nice and deep.
He won't let me give it to him.
Is it still warm? Is that why?
Hold on.
It's still warm, man.
It's been in his ear.
Nestled safely away.
Not that in mine.
Nestled safely away. It's not like I got herpes on
syphilis. Not ear plug.
Hey.
It's not like I got herpes on syphilis.
It's not
part of the ear.
Not like you don't.
Yeah, it's not like I don't either. That's true.
Hey, wow.
Super AIDS.
Do you want to know where his ears have been? I mean,
yeah, detached to the side of my head. It's not like they're detachable, man.
I was gonna say now, if you're talking about what his ears have heard, that's another story. But
no, it's what his ears have been in contact with.
What kind of weird kinky stuff are you doing with those ears, man?
I did actually use a Q-tip earlier after I took a shower tonight, so maybe that's what he's.
Yeah, but were you making like moaning noises when you were using it? Like, what was going on?
Have you ever stuck a Q-tip?
Is that the Q-tip you reused for a month?
No.
And then he saves.
I heard that conversation.
And then he saves it.
Have you ever cleaned out your ear with a, you know, what we're just talking about?
A Q-tip.
Q-tip, he sounded like Homer Simpson. Oh.
It does feel really good. It does feel really good. That's all I'm going to say. It feels.
I refer to that as an eargasm.
Yeah, it definitely gives you an eargasm.
Creepy. Oh, yeah.
Well, then I could kind of understand why he doesn't want that earring then.
Yeah.
Actually, wouldn't that make my ears cleaner?
Not if you had some liquid coming out after the fact.
Like when you do clean your ears out.
He does a little spurt after the fact.
Kids, I can understand if I had someone's legs wrapped around my head.
If you're spurting out of your ears, I think you need medical assistance.
Well, that's what the nurse said, but then the doctor said I had no insurance.
What fluid
so.
Is spurting out of your ear? You need medical assistance immediately.
Damn, I cannot get taunt on this thing.
Oh, that's because I pulled it with a spell. There you go.
Oh.
Yeah, I can only sit still for so long. I don't know how well I'm going to be at a wizard class. All I want to do is keep pulling.
Yeah, that's, eventually you'll be able to kite
pretty
things.
Good because
yeah,
you can quad.
Yeah, I think I've been playing our monks too long. Like, the monk just never sits down. I'm, like, still in that mentality to just go through and power level through everything down here.
Now you're making me want to play the monks.
They're really fun, right? I mean, holy crap. Can they tank like nobody's business?
Bro.
Shady Mercenaries up again, guys.
/ gem.
Yeah, I guess, you know, but it's kind of early to use that, isn't it? I mean, at level 4, level 5, if you're already using gems, I think you're a little bit in trouble. You should probably go get the ears from what were you guys saying those were going for too? The ones from Highkeep.
Well, last night someone bought 3 off of me for 100 apiece.
Jeez, man, that is crazy.
I don't think that's the regular price. I think someone was just desperate.
But for what? Like, the faction is okay, but the experience is only decent. I mean, why would you pay 100 platinum for that?
Because they're...
I'll have to turn one in the next time I get one, see what I get.
I mean, I know...
He's like, he was red to me. If he wasn't going to turn... He wouldn't have gotten very good experience. But he might be trading it off to one of his alts.
I know you can turn them in all the way up to level 30 and get some decent experience, but still, that's a lot of money to be paying for it.
Yeah,
I think he was nuts, but who am I to argue with it?
Yeah, for 100 platinum, I wouldn't be turning it down. Have you guys been over to Highkeep recently?
Just last night.
No, I'm saying for like, for Warp Jester.
Oh, no, these are effectively the largest characters we have on the server.
That's right. And you guys did try running through that area a little while back, High Pass.
Well, looked at it and turned around that way.
What side did you guys come from?
I'm sorry?
Go for it, man.
I loved High Keep. When I was playing on live server,
spent
a lot of my life there. That's where I hit my level 20. That's where I got my last name. It was a lot of fun.
What'd you pick as your last name?
Taxi service.
Hey, Warped. Ask Carrie for a nice new joke. I think she might have one for you.
Pulling a spider.
Just say it so that it's not caught by the microphones.
I think this is going to be an after the recording.
It's a short one. You'll get a giggle. Well, actually, no, it's kind of long.
What? Holy crap, dude.
Mark. Ow.
Oh, do I not have throwing?
A mushroom walks into the bar, walks up to the bartender. Bartender says, "We don't serve your kind here." He says, "Why? Oh, I'm a fun guy."
Oh, man. Put a bump.
Or the crickets. I like the crickets.
It's a short, child-friendly joke. Okay.
You mean kind of like a pirate walks into a bar with a steering wheel attached to his crotch? The bartender looks at him and says, "Hey, what's with the steering wheel attached to your crotch?" He goes, "Arr, you mean this? Been driving me nuts all day."
Yeah, that's crickets. Not a kid-friendly joke. Wait, hold on. Let me get the crickets out.
Kids, don't look that up.
Who are these kids that watch? Do you have a lot of kids watching your your channel?
Tell that to a kid.
You know, I have my kids watching my channel.
Yeah, I got about 30% that are under 18. Well, now,
I've seen some of your videos, Wicked.
Warped. Things on my channel.
Do you get that kind of demographic display on it on the people?
Yeah, I can see everything on there.
Now, recently, I wanted to ask you about something. Older and, you had a channel update. You had a channel update, and you were talking. Are you guys trying to go more kid friendly, or
Oh God, no! I mean, okay. I
just wants everybody.
I try to be civil on some things. Like I said, my 8 and 9 year old like to watch my videos, and so they have an understanding that if like my Minecraft videos come out, that's pretty safe. I'm trying to keep this, you know, within reason. Like for as bad as we are, this is pretty civil.
Yeah,
wait till later episodes of Rocket League.
Oh, yeah. I've seen some of the Rocket League. Yeah.
We're still in the tame episodes of it. It gets worse.
It was brutal.
I'm just going to say this now. Congratulations, AC, on your 7.1 billionth subscriber.
I think you're a little early on that one. I mean, that would be amazing if that actually happened, but...
Yeah, can
holy
you imagine
crap.
If somebody actually got everybody on the planet as a subscriber?
No, that's never going to happen.
Because
yeah,
there's some people on the planet
gonna
who don't have houses.
Never do it.
Wee, wee, wee. Never going to do it.
Master Pain's inside.
Incoming giant.
I think somebody will eventually. They'll get everybody.
There's no way you could get everybody. It's just not possible. Because you're going to have babies who are not going to... I mean, it's just physically impossible for something like that to happen.
Yeah, what about the people who live in like, the deep jungles
right,
who don't
have computers and technology?
Computers or even electricity.
Like, we're not talking about realistic majority.
Oh, if you're talking about like the majority of the internet, maybe if somebody was like a superstar on YouTube, but...
PewDiePie.
I don't think
even PewDiePie.
Category,
yeah, I was going to say... Because if you're a gamer, you kind of limit yourself to games. If you're into comedy, you limit yourself to that. You would have to be just like this broad spectrum that everybody liked and really, really wanted to watch.
Either that or a young, very hot woman.
No, because I don't know necessarily if all women want to watch really hot women. Like, you'd lose that demographic, so you'd have to appeal to everybody.
Yeah.
Hey, women, females are the only ones I know that can get more subscribers than everybody else, so...
Well, yeah, there's that inherent sex appeal thing that...
I think looking at a beautiful woman is fine, but she also has to have substance. If she doesn't have substance, it's going to be a flash pan, and then she's going to be without any subscribers.
I think the same goes for both.
Wait, what? Wait, hold on. What are you saying there, Warp? I heard something about a cup.
Please do not play two girls.
How much substance? C cup?
Please, please, please don't do that.
No. I'm just saying, you know, if e-girls who play video games, but really all they're doing, they're not even really playing games and stuff like that. They're just showing their, you know, they're showing their assets. Let's say that.
I've seen a lot of channels. I'm not gonna barrel into it, but I've seen a lot of channels that are kind of annoying to me because it is just that is a cute little girl with a low cut top. I would say, I mean, there's one of the soap twos. She couldn't play the game for crap, which is, you know, whatever. But she had probably almost one quarter of her screen was the face cam. So you couldn't see the boobs.
Yeah, I'm looking.
That's ridiculous, man. They gotta have some substance. I mean, or else I'm just not gonna watch. I'm not interested. I might watch for a couple minutes because it's a beautiful girl, but if she's not actually doing anything worse, then
well,
yeah. But what about the?
She's like the wrestler, you know, Triple H.
What about the flip side of that? Somebody who looks like Brad Pitt sitting there with no shirt on playing video games. Like that's gonna happen eventually.
But AC, you just said you would rather watch Brad Pitt.
No, I said what about...
Yeah, that's what I said.
That's exactly what I said, guys. Totally like, want to see when those shirt up.
Topless.
Bring it on, baby.
Demographics don't have to watch Brad Pitt play games.
Yeah, see, I kind of like the wrestler, Triple H.
That was a good pull,
AC. That's what I watch.
Well, I have no life. Why would I be pulling right now?
I don't know.
I'm a wizard.
I thought you were pulling. I was like, what's going on?
I'm a wizard, Harry.
You're a wizard, Harry. You're a wizard, Harry.
I fell in the water.
Baby Jesus.
I fell in the water again.
Sweet baby Jesus with some barbecue sauce.
Help her landlord murmuring.
I want my baby back, baby back, baby back.
Baby back.
Baby back. Baby back. Barbecue sauce.
I'm bopping the balls.
Chilies.
That is not a song I need stuck in my head. Thank you very much.
Chilies. Now you know what Doom does to me every day.
Yeah, what was I singing all night last night?
No. We are not reminding you. You are not getting that one back. That is gone.
I'm a Bobby girl. Talk about that's quality music right there.
Let's go dancing.
I'm a 42%, sir.
I just want an earring.
Pink fluffy unicorns.
42%, sir.
Go check that mob for an earring for me.
Yeah, have we gotten his earring already?
No. I know, man. God, let's go somewhere else.
Yeah, jeez, that is...
That's all I'm waiting for is that one mob to give me my earring so we can leave.
Is that all we...
Somebody give their earring to the mob right before we kill it, and then we can kill it and be like, "Oh, it dropped an earring! It's a spider. I don't understand why, but it dropped it. Yeah, we got it."
Look, the spider beetle dropped a rat's tooth earring. How amazing!
If I smell Kithis on it, it ain't happening.
I don't know what's more disturbing is that you're smelling the item, or that you know what Kithis smells like.
If you smell me on it.
Yeah, I can smell you through a bacon-infused house, man.
That's what my mama keeps telling me, dude. And I'm like, Mom, seriously.
What?
I love you. I love you, Mom. Why you gotta be so mean?
Sorry, I just blissed out the idea of a bacon-infused house.
Yeah.
That would be
it's
amazing.
It's so easy to sleep.
Bacon on toast.
And you just lay down and you have just such great dreams.
I don't know. In a bacon-infused house, I don't know if I could lay down or I just roll around.
Bacon's like chicken for me. Chicken's my best.
Bacon's not like chicken.
Yeah, but chicken is my bacon. I like chicken as much as you guys like bacon.
I don't.
I'll tell you what you do.
Oh, I do, man. The stuff that I can do with chicken, man, my chicken marsala, my chicken parmesan, all the dishes I can make with chicken. I pan sear it just by itself. It traps all the moisture in it, man. Chicken is friggin' awesome, dude.
I can get 12 pounds of bacon in like 15 minutes.
And the thing about chicken
here's
is
the thing. Here's the thing.
Ahead,
you take anything you want. Take any dish that has chicken in it. The best possible dish possible. and I guarantee you I can beat it. Because all you gotta do is take your dish and wrap it in bacon.
Yeah, it's true. They even have bacon and ice cream, man. It's crazy.
Yeah.
I don't think chicken marsala would taste good wrapped in bacon, dude.
Maybe not wrapped in it, but put some sprinkles of it in there.
Challenge accepted, sir. You put it over, I'll wrap it in bacon.
Bacon is so awesome.
West Coast, here I come.
Bacon added to bacon can improve bacon.
Bacon is so bad for you, but nobody cares.
I would just like to move out there and live in one of your guys' trees. You guys live near the Redwood Forest. That would be awesome. I could just build a tree house.
No. We live in it.
Not near.
See that? Man, I want to see a redwood before I die. I mean, we got the George Kilmer Forest out where I live, and some of the trees in there are 800 or 900 years old, and they are massive. But I don't think they're anything compared to an actual redwood.
So here's the thing.
You can redwood build a house trees, out of a redwood.
Redwood trees are, in fact, actually large weeds.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
The characteristics of how redwoods grow is characteristic of a weed. That is exactly how they act in every aspect. They are effectively a weed.
Yeah, here's
well, it's kind of like a human. Humans actually act like a virus.
But is weed legal?
It is now, man. Depending on where you live, it is now.
Okay, can I live in one of your trees? I'm coming. Mama, I'm coming home.
I'll be bringing two giant sewer rats.
And when your house burns down, man, you can stand right next to it and being completely happy.
Oh, dude, I hope the redwood forest doesn't burn down.
I was saying because you're living in a giant weed.
Something like that. Something really sad.
See, the thing is with the amount of people in the world, even if we went at half the density of...
It's my weapon, guys. It's my weapon.
No, what it ain't.
Call dibs. Okay.
The bastard. Just stick it in your ear. He won't want it, man.
Like it.
Yeah.
First. It's too late. He got to it first. And he's from New York, so you know he's dirty.
Yeah.
I actually did a licking trick to my son the other day with a bagel. Didn't work. I told him it was my bagel. He looked at me. I grabbed
New
the
York.
Bagel.
I'm just kidding, New York.
And he looks at me, grabs a bagel, wipes on his pants, and walks off with it.
I actually didn't mean to talk bad about New York. I meant New Jersey, guys. Sorry about that.
I'm sorry, New York. I didn't mean to talk about New Jersey. I was insulting.
Let's offend the whole state of New Jersey instead of the whole state of New York.
Yeah. State of New York is a little bigger than the state of New Jersey. And we only have like 8 million more people than New Jersey. So, yeah, I would rather offend New Jersey than New
York. Well, now, New Jersey is the Garden State, guys. Probably one of the most beautiful places in the world.
Yeah, I can.
Well, I don't know about that.
start backpedaling. You might slow down soon.
Compared to Detroit, maybe.
Please check out Hydra's Inc. He has pictures and video of his the place he lives at. I'm pretty sure with some Google Maps and triangulation, you can. Yeah.
I have many guns. So I'll just and an old World War II tank that I am refurbishing.
I'll give you a hint. He lives near trees.
Yes, I do.
Come on, friend. I want a tank.
And easiest way to do it, just show up there with a life-size cutout of, name?
Darth Vader.
No.
Do it with Darth Vader. You're getting his attention.
I would open the door. I would get the door open for Darth Vader probably faster than anything else if I saw a life-size Darth Vader outside.
Well, there you go.
Princess Leia.
It's actually Darth Vader, and he's pissed at you.
Well, then I would probably go out the back door.
You do know that Darth Vader is one of the worst smokers ever.
Just because he got smoked by a volcano, I don't think that qualifies him as a smoker.
No, I think it's the breathing. The
Vader, my boy.
So now you're insulting the breath impaired, huh?
I'm a breath impaired.
Breathing impaired?
He hates people with asthma.
Holy crap.
Actually, you're right. I do have asthma.
So he hates other people and hates himself.
Let the hate mail begin, guys.
I just hate anything with a heartbeat.
Well, that's fair.
Yeah, I guess that is fair. You just hate everybody then, huh?
Yeah.
As long as you hate everybody equally.
What drops the item that we're looking for? Is it the rats over here, or is it the other things?
Yeah, it's the rats, the injured rat.
So they somebody, can
Who does not have a golden locket?
I got a golden ticket.
Lab said he doesn't need one.
Oh, buddy.
I don't need one either.
Yeah.
Okay. They're just not.
I'll never remember to switch out to it when I sell, so I could care less.
AC, do you have a necklace?
I have a neck item, and it's better than that.
So, we'll A-Lads and Carowin, what do you think about the P99 server? What's your experience been over here so far?
Yeah.
Honey?
Spell it.
I would have to say it is pretty cool. My first experience actually was when I was trying to get to Freeport from Peniel, and I really didn't want to run it. You know, my whole record with corpse runs and all. Didn't want to do that. But I just put out a shout asking for help for a port, and somebody came right over from a guild called Dial-A-Port, I think it was.
Yeah.
And they just brought me out for free. I thought, okay.
For free?
For free. Yeah. And they gave me money.
They gave you money? Yeah, see, the community on this game is so awesome.
Can I just say, with that little feedback loop you had there, you just sounded so cool.
That makes me sound cool is awesome. Really.
Yeah, my wife gets a port from Peniel out to Freeport, and the druid ends up paying her 100 plat.
Oh my god. How come I never get any of that? I gotta start playing female characters more.
You got something like that on the monks, man. You've gotten plenty of free stuff from people.
Yeah.
I got one free
400
thing
plat the other day. Yeah.
That's a quest I could have done.
No, that was one time and he was doing it to the whole zone.
Does that matter? Like, does it matter that he's doing it to everybody?
Nice to everybody. Yeah.
Yeah, like, that's still nice to you. I mean, 100 platinum is 100 platinum.
There's a difference between being nice to a person and being nice to everybody.
Yeah, it makes you. It means you're
everybody else too.
Exactly. Yeah, it means you're a better person because you're being nice to everybody. So.
Yeah,
the community here is amazing.
I agree, but what I'm saying is I constantly hear about people saying, oh, yeah, I just started, and this random guy just gave me a whole set of gear, and, oh, this person gave me enough money to get all my spells up to level 50 and stuff. I've never had anything like that happen.
You do realize that it's a nice...
You just got 400 plat the other day.
I know, that's what we're saying. Like, it's not something you can count on. It's not something that they owe you. They're just doing it out of the kindness of their heart. So
I'm not saying that anybody owes you or anything like that. I'm just saying that I've never had that experience where it's just a person saying, "I want to help you." Sure,
you
I got
that.
Lucky.
I mean, that
I got
that is
the 400. Yeah, the 400 platinum.
Yeah,
I mean, wow, that's crazy.
Yeah, he even told you not to tell anybody else.
Yeah,
I mean,
he didn't
got that experience.
He didn't give 400 platinum to all of us. He gave it just to you, man. He gave you more platinum
so
than anybody else.
He singled you out. Yeah.
So you have there's your experience right there. You're just not looking. You're just not seeing it.
Well, no, I want to.
I agree.
There you are, Jess. I want to encounter that one situation, like they were saying, is, you know, oh, just out of the blue, this guy was like, yeah, you know, I just want to encounter it so I can find those people.
I don't know. Maybe I'm missing something here, but that was out of the blue when you got that money.
Not really. He was helping everybody, and we just ran over really fast.
So you got the port over. How did that run go? I mean, I know, but for the people who maybe didn't get to see that.
How many times did I die?
I didn't want it.
Well, you didn't die once from that.
You didn't die at all.
You just got tired and laid down and closed your eyes. I
helped out, you know, getting her over here, but all she had to do was just get out to Tox Forest, and then they ported over to West Common Lands. And she just ran lickety split through east and into Freeport.
Now, let me ask you both a question. Oh, I'm sorry, were you not finished? Go ahead, brother.
No, that's fine.
What I want to ask you is there a future class that either of you are looking forward to playing? Is there another class, another race, anything in particular that you guys want to play after these two characters get sufficiently leveled up?
Huh. Oh, sweetie, is there anything in particular that you're... Well, I know you said Beast Lord, but don't have that.
No, I don't have that option.
Hey, how many times do I got to tell you not to call me sweetie when others are around?
I know, I mean, I personally... I played a lot of the different classes with EQ Live, and at this point, what I've more or less just been doing is just going through and recreating the characters I've had. So, you know, my first character on EQ Live was A-Labs the Wizard. And then a couple of the ones I'm, you know, like I got Jet the Lizard that I just started.
And he's a monk, right? Jet's a monk, correct?
Monk, correct.
Okay, all right.
So I'm just kind of reliving and rehashing the old ones because that's what I'm familiar with.
Yeah, that's the same thing I'm doing too, brother. I totally appreciate what you're saying. My first character was Sith Lord, a cleric, and my first character back in the day was also a Dark Elf cleric. So I understand what you're doing. So now, is there, okay, beyond Jet, is there anything else what's next? I mean, you got a monk, you got a gnome wizard. Is there anything, is there another iconic character that you played back in the day that you really want to relive?
You coming up, but
most likely I'm going to go after, probably do my shaman next.
Oh, nice. Okay, now what race would you choose for that? Because I want to make a troll shaman, troll. I believe. Oh, yeah, troll? Cool, man. Yeah, maybe we can start off troll shamans together. I think that would be awesome.
Absolutely.
Shaman. I just think the regen. Yeah, I think the regen.
Yeah, troll shaman is the regen. Yeah.
And plus you can stack regen, and then you, you know, it offsets your. What is that where they take their own cannibalize? Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, they can basically themselves for it.
Yeah.
Yeah. The shaman was a challenge into.
I've heard that the shaman is a challenging character to play, a challenging tune.
It really is. I mean, it's very rewarding.
I've also heard wizards are pretty challenging too. Do you find that to be true? No, really?
I have no least. The wizards are so straightforward. Well, that's the one thing you have to get help. But that's not really the class aspect that's difficult. It's just the learning how to kite kind of thing.
Okay.
Yeah. That's just wizards actually are a good starting class for anybody who's just getting into the game. Warrior, wizard. Those are easy things to get into because they're pretty straightforward in terms of what they do, what their function is, and how you utilize them. They're minimal, forgive me, but like minimal button press, if you will.
Yeah.
Whereas the complete other extreme end, you've got like shaman, bard, enchanter. Okay. Those are the other extreme ends of characters because those guys take a lot more understanding.
I think the hardest class to play is Enchanter. Well, to play correctly.
Yeah, I'm actually kind of struggling with Thum right now because he's not able to hold aggro as well as I would like. And that's frustrating. I love playing Thum. I want to play him. He's probably the tune that I want to play the most. But it is frustrating for me to not be able to hold aggro like I want in the group and stuff like that. Especially when the group is depending on me to get aggro and to hold it because I can take the most... the best beating, so that's a little frustrating for me, but I still love Thum with all my heart, man. He's an awesome character.
I told you, take off your mask and show your face.
Thum doesn't wear a mask.
you say that.
He doesn't, man. He just wears that crappy helmet. It's actually not a bad helmet. I just don't like the way it looks.
Give me my Smurfin earring, okay?
Is this the injured guy? The injured rat?
No, we killed him a couple seconds ago. He dropped the neck piece again.
Oh, okay.
I just want...
We gotta help Kieran, guys.
I'm trying.
Alright, cool. Oh, yeah, he gone. He dead. He's down!
All I want is a flipping earring so we can flip flapping flocker out of here.
You know, it's not even that great of an earring. Really, we could just give you one of ours.
No.
You guys,
Actually...
It's a matter of principle.
Yeah, apparently, he really wants to get that earring.
Yes.
The video's at 33 minutes, guys. Just letting you know. Just a reminder.
Woo. Yeah, I should probably wrap that up.
Yeah, so let's do a little outro here.
All right, who started?
Warp? That would be Warp, yeah.
Warp. That's all yours.
Yes, sir.
All
right.
So, in conclusion, now. All right, guys. Well, anyways, we're getting a little bit longer in the episode, so we're going to wrap it up, but. As always, we certainly do appreciate you joining us, and it's always a blast, pardon me the pun here, but to have a chance to play with these chaps on this server. If you have any interest in things like this, you have any questions about it, as always, please do feel free to leave comments down below. We love talking back to you. We love getting a chance to jabber back and forth. And of course, if you happen to play this type of game on this server, feel free to poke at us and say hi, because we love getting a chance to actually say hi back.
yeah, we love you like hippies in the 60s.
And on that note, guys, AC Gamer. Enough,
folks. He's just kidding.
No, hippies loved everybody,
guys,
man.
We really do appreciate you guys watching out there, everybody who watches.
Especially
those like of you who take the time to say hello in-game. What was the guy's name who sent us a tell earlier and said he loved our videos? I forget your name, guy, but we did give you a shout-out earlier. We just, I mean, that makes us feel good, guys, and we really appreciate it, so thank you.
We like the warm and fuzzy.
We do.
Makes all right, guys. Us feel like we're actually doing something.
Uh-huh. So, for me, Warp Jester Gaming, for AC Gamer, for Hydros Inc., and everybody else around here, as always, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe, stay happy, stay healthy. Good night.
Subscribe, guys.